Remote live stream production is becoming a very popular thing. You could have somebody remote produce your own live stream so you can just focus on delivering the content and showing up on camera, or you could produce other people's live streams as a service. In today's video, what you need for remote live production, tips for getting the smoothest production possible, and how you can do it simply using a service like Restream. How amazing would it be to be able to just stand in front of the camera, deliver your content, and have somebody else throwing all of the fancy graphics, switching between you and your interview guest, et cetera, et cetera? That takes all the pressure off of you. On the flip side, how amazing would it be to be able to offer this as a service for your clients, or to be able to offer this as part of your job inside of your company, which makes you even more valuable? You doing all of the work from a remote location while the audience never even has to hear or see you. So the concept of a remote live production is pretty simple. You as the producer will be controlling everything, and the hosts, the people delivering the content of that live stream, will be coming into your production as guests, and you just won't be seen or heard. Now, keep in mind here that remote live production can be done pretty simply or pretty complex, and your decisions around how to go about this will depend on the size of the live stream, the importance of the live stream, and a number of other factors, including how much you're charging. There are three things you need for a remote live stream production. Number one, you need a live streaming application. This can be done either through a downloadable software onto your computer like Ecamm or OBS or vMix, and that's what we call a level 3 live streaming service, or you can use a cloud-based service where you don't download anything and everything is taken care of through a browser. That's what we call a level 2. Number 2, a good internet connection. I'd really like you to have at least 10 megabits per second upload speed, that is different than download speed, so that you have a solid internet connection. You can get by with 8 megabits per second upload, but anything less is potentially going to cause you some problems. And if your clients are paying for the service, you don't want to risk it. Make sure you test your internet speed to be sure, and don't forget to plug in via Ethernet. Do not go wireless for this. The third thing you need is a computer. Of course, you're not gonna do this from your phone. Please don't try. We have a video for Mac specs and PC specs linked to in the description. So if you're not sure if your computer can handle it, be sure to watch those videos. And one other thing you might need are graphics. If your client does not have graphics already, then you might need to create them. You can charge additional for that service, by the way. We have a tutorial on how to actually create graphics in Canva, linked to in the description, or you could just get pre-made graphics from the Live Streaming Pros store, linked to in the description, so that you don't have to do any additional work. Let's dive in. Now, keep in mind, you can do remote live production on any software that you choose on a Mac or a PC, like vMix, Ecamm, OBS. But for the purposes of this demo, I'm actually gonna be using Restream Live Studio because it is super simple, super easy to use, and you can have, depending on the plan you choose, up to 10 guests joining you, and you can simulcast to multiple different platforms at the same time. If you want to use Restream for your live streams or your remote live production, go to livestreamingpros.com/restream because that link will get you a $10 credit on your account. Woohoo! Demo time! Go ahead and enter Live Studio. Be sure to configure your camera settings and audio here, and you can go into advanced settings as well. Make sure your production is highest quality possible depending on your internet connection. The link to get your guests to join is right here. Invite guests, and then copy that link and give that to them. You can load in all of your graphics and assets right here on the right side in the graphics tab. By the way, we have a full tutorial video on this. You can click the link in the description. Once your guest joins, then go ahead and toggle them on so they're part of the production. Now, keep in mind that they cannot hear you unless your camera is also toggled on, but when you're testing your scenes, you can toggle yourself off and then use the private chat function to communicate with them to test all of your scenes. Have your guests test their audio. Using the layout options at the bottom, you can adjust what the audience is seeing. Before you go live, make sure that you turn off your camera so that your audio and video is not going out to stream. Super simple, super easy. You're done and ready to go. How cool is that? Right, Abby? If you've learned a thing or two, go ahead and hit that like button, subscribe, and ring that bell so you don't miss out on more. Now I've got some tips for you to get the smoothest possible production. Before every production, restart your computer, close all apps that aren't needed, get your kids off Netflix, and open your live streaming application. Verify all of your graphics and assets are loaded in and working properly. Also, turn off all background syncing. Google Drive, Dropbox will kill your production, so pause those. Send your guest a guest checklist at least a week before so they know they have everything they need. Bring your guest into your production for a tech check at least 30 minutes before you go live. If it's a more complicated production, do it a lot earlier. That tech check should include things like their audio, test their audio and make sure they're not peaking or that they're not too low. How is their framing? Do they look like this? Fix their framing. How's their lighting? Are they blown out by a window? And double check that they are wearing earphones so that there's no audio feedback. Don't you worry, we've got a guest checklist already made for you so you don't have to do that work. You can download it with a link in the description. Go through the run of show with the guests and the graphics to make sure that everything is in order. Be sure to communicate very clearly with your guests so they understand exactly what's going to happen through the process and remind them before you go live to have fun, to smile, and to look into the camera. And finally, make sure that your camera and audio are not on and going out to the viewers. Then go live! And hey, if you or someone you know needs remote live production, then check out our services at livestreamingpros.com/producer. If you want to learn more about Restream, tips and tricks to get the most out of it, check out this playlist. And of course, you can always join us on a live Q&A to get your questions answered. I'll see you over there.